And so we return, and I'm more or less at the same point, and the raft is gone once more, but I am not going back there for her. She is just that slow. Not even gonna humor them. What? Okay, they have bombs. Oh, that's interesting.
You thought you could stand aside?
I wanted no part of politics. I'm a Witcher. I'm neutral.
We fought for those we love. You scorn that, for you'll never understand it.
A machine created to kill. You had no choice. Your time has passed.
You're obsolete. The world has no use for you. Lay down your sword and rest, Geralt.
Have the courage to face me, Jacques. Stop hiding behind specters and illusions. I'll find you.
You won't get the chance.
Surrender!
So they actually came together in their hate for me. How cute. Oh well, I guess I don't get to loot him. Or I don't even get to meet this guy either. Well, looky here.
Look, Alvin.
An illusion, Shani.
And he disappeared.
How stubborn you are. I could use you to shepherd my sheep during the first years of winter.
I doubt you mean it. You stole our secrets from Kaer Morhen, used them for the worst ends.
I needed witches, but knew the secrets of mutation had been lost. You witches had it all, but lacked courage and vision. I merely did what you desired in your hearts.
You took them as if they were your own. You're a thief, a hypocrite.
Are you incapable of seeing the golden path of my dreams? My knights will explain it to you in a way you will understand.
Yeah, and my Igni spell will explain it to them in the way they can understand as well. And they just all exploded. Oh, they actually have good potions. I guess it's a bit of a shame that they fell down to... their corpses fell down. What can you do?
Look, Geralt. Humans. Monsters. Easy to mistake one for the other.
I trust your judgment.
The Grand Master is the vilest kind of criminal. We need to stop him.
Let's go then.
Just like old times.
And now he's a werewolf.
Colder than a witch's tit. I'll take the streets of Azima any day.
A twist.
Let me tell you, the cutscene director for this game, he loved slow-mo.
Go on alone.
Why?
None can enter the heart of the vision besides you. The Grand Master won't allow it.
Very well. Thank you.
Be safe.
Okay, and that was the last chance. Oh, I was so close to a level. Oh well, that was the last chance to make some potions. I'm just looking at the quest that that we never finished. I was so close to a level. Oh well. Let's see. Else, to be honest. Okay, and now let's eat up the potions that I have made up. A few of them are unique. Never gonna get to use that then.
All that prep for nothing.
Yeah, all they give me is extra levels pretty much, but I don't actually get a chance to level anymore. Oh well. I guess I could have done this before. I can't blame the game for that. I guess I should also, since I've already saved, I'll get jacked up on all of the potions that I can find. Tawny Owl. Swallow Owl get... let's see. I'm gonna be mostly needing this one. That one does, and for how long? 7 hours. Okay, we'll be fine. This fight isn't gonna take 7 hours.
Or is it?
Maybe it will.
Now, do you see the need to act, whatever the price? Geralt, open your eyes. Open your mind.
They treat people like you at St. Lebiota's hospital.
By pursuing me, you proved me right. You faced the dangers that humanity faces and survived.
Jacques de Aldersburg, your dream is over.
Patience. You may yet change your mind. Imagine thousands traversing an icy wasteland. Could you defend them? You and a handful of witches ridden with doubt, like Berengar? Impossible. Only the greater brothers can do that. But they need to be taught and led. They need you.
Okay, so he's basically offering us to train the mutants. And the choices are, I also have an offer. Surrender. Withdraw your mutants. Humble yourself before the king. You will save many lives. And second option, enough. Our swords will speak for us.
Our swords will speak for us.
Enough. Our swords will speak for us.
How confident you seem. A painful lesson awaits.
Okay, good. They picked the right one. And there goes that. Harsh. I will take one of these. Oh. I want to use this. Fucking hell. Game, left click to use, hello.
Nah.
Okay, what?
Destiny.
Salamandra is dying, soon to be a memory.
Salamandra means nothing. It was but a particle of chaos, the tool of the madman you just slew. Your past, your destiny, the reasons for your resurrection, all remain unknown.
Words, words, words.
You've always used them ably to mask uncertainty and fear. I once promised I would follow you.
Gibberish, Spectre. Tell me what you want or disappear. I believe that's what I said, and I will say it again if you don't get to the point.
I come for the soul of the man you killed.
One second.
Reflect on your deeds, Witcher. I stood near you when you arrived at Kaer Morhen, an omen of its downfall. I observed as you judged the villagers of the outskirts, leaving only blood and fire behind you. You brought death upon Raymond, endangered Shani, mindful only of your goals. Chaos followed in your wake. You slaughtered dozens with your witch's sword. You helped create the foundations for the Order's fanatical reign. You left Vizima in chaos, only to bring destruction upon murky waters. Every one of your decisions brought further devastation. Each choice you made led to greater evil. Vizima blazes. The Order and the Scoia'tael bleed, Temeria. Does your neutrality not taste bitter?
Stop.
Do not deny it, Witcher. You are my greatest champion, a perfect means of destruction. Wherever you walk, death and chaos follow. Now, as it was years ago, accept it. Do not fight it. Give up to me yet another man you destroyed.
Jacques de Aldersburg is mine.
You dare to oppose me? I sense your weakness as your life seeps from your wounds. With every drop, death draws nearer. You stand no chance against me. Yield to me.
All right, how much of that did you catch?
Only a little bit of it, so give me the short version.
Short version? He really likes us because we bring death and destruction everywhere we go. He basically wants to claim the soul of this bad guy. He asks us to kill it for to basically give him his soul. There are two options. Never. This is between me and him. And take him. I don't care what fate he meets.
Ooh, both of these are really good.
And one of them basically means we get an additional sort of part to this boss fight, if I recall correctly.
You know, since we're being Blarney, let's go with I don't care.
I guess that is the Blarney way to not give a damn.
Take him.
Pretty much.
I don't care what fate he meets.
From now on, the soul of Jacques de Aldersburg, whom you knew under another name, belongs to me. Do your duty.
Gladly.
Now he said, this guy, Jacques Aldersburg, who we knew by another name. In case you didn't catch that.
Yeah, I did.
That sword is for monsters.
Here. He had a talisman on him.
You're awake, Geralt. I was getting worried.
Dandelion, where's the Grand Master?
A few steps away. He's dead. For a minute there, I thought you were gone too.
Hardly a pleasant nap. Was I out long?
Long enough. The fighting has been quelled. Foltas has regained control. However, Triss supported him. The effects have been shocking.
Is she all right?
She's fine. She stayed by you until I arrived. Then she had to go. You know, political duties.
Caught between the king, her sorceress friends, and her personal life.
What about you? Did you succeed?
Yes.
I'll take the final element from Jacques and close this chapter.
Good thing that we didn't decide to take that extra boss fight, because I didn't have much toxicity left on me.
Yeah. You're lucky Barney doesn't give a shit.
Exactly. So, secrets stolen from Kaer Morhen. We finally did this quest that we set out on and pretty much completely forgot about it towards the end. Because there were so many different things that were so much more important. And we gained a level for no fucking reason.
And yep.
Dimitrium amulet. A small amulet made of blue metal. If you remember, we gave a similar amulet to somebody in the past.
Was it Dandelion?
No.
Darn.
We gave it to Alvin. Because he had those magical powers and terrible dreams. And visions.
Right, yeah.
So, did you recover everything?
Know what I found on the Grandmaster? A Dimeridium pendant.
The one you gave Alvin?
I don't know. It looks the same, but older. He must have worn it under his armor for years.
A true keepsake, perhaps.
Maybe it was his way of repelling hostile magic. Or it was there to control inborn abilities, unrelenting visions.
That's something we'll never know.
It doesn't matter. Jacques de Aldersburg, if that was his name, is dead. End of story.
What's next, Geralt?
What do you mean?
Come now. You've recovered what was stolen, punished those who hurt you, you played politics and dismantled conspiracies. You've loved, you've killed, you've come a long way, Geralt. What do you intend to do now?
Okay, now we have three options. What do we intend to do now? I'm tired, Dandelion. I want peace and quiet. Second option. Only now do I feel my new life is beginning. And third option, I don't know.
I love how casual that third one is, so let's go with that one.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Not to be trite, but as always, you'll be the leaf carried by the wind. Not to be trite, but as always, you'll be the leaf carried by the wind on an eternal voyage in search of purpose and meaning.
Enough philosophy, Dandelion. I did what I had to, and now I'll be on my way.
What can I say? Godspeed on your path, Witcher. It seemed the conflict between the Order of the Flaming Rose and the Scoia'tael would turn Vizima into charred ruins. Foltest, however, found a solution. He let the two sides bleed each other. The Order's power waned quickly following the Grand Master's mysterious death. The flower of elven youth perished. Fighting in Vizima's streets, there were no victors. The non-human uprising weakened Temeria, and Foltest realized he would need capable diplomats. Triss Marigold became a royal advisor. Sorceresses gained influence. The king punished or exiled those who had plotted against him in his absence. They were, of course, soon replaced by others. Common folk saw no difference. They were too busy licking their wounds, seeking loved ones. Few people knew what had actually happened in those days in Vizima. They were those who destiny had brought together with Geralt of Rivia. Yet, they chose to remain silent. What then happened to the Witcher? That is a different tale entirely.
In no small part to you. For your toil, a worthy pouch of gold.
Your Highness. Master.
And that was The Witcher.
Was that the same Witcher guy we met earlier?
No. Completely different.
Oh, okay.
And it wouldn't be explained what Witcher it was until years later when they made a sequel.
Hmm.
And I'm really glad that they did, because this has turned out to be such a fantastic franchise in the end. Its baby steps are very tumbly, to be fair. I mean, as we've seen, I'm not going to pretend this game was flawless. I made many remarks about how it isn't. It doesn't do things that are completely unique to it and nothing else. Like the choice system that actually means something, that actually carries importance, a lot of quests that actually influence your main objective, that are actually connected in a, you know, non-scripted way, a lot of ways in which it feels different every time you play it, which is why I played it through like 4 or 5 times by now. And each time I found something new.
Like the fact that you can go through the whole game without having sex.
That was the biggest discovery. I don't think there is a proof of that on the internet. And I don't think that the game acknowledges that that is possible. You know, except for that one time where Triss raped us, basically.
Yeah. But that's why she's the worst waifu.
And when we get to the second one, she's the only waifu, sadly. But that's why she's
I think you mean there's no waifus in the second one.
Well, we can very easily ignore her. I know you can do that because I was pissed off.
Yeah.
But yeah. This was a long project. It was a lot of fun for me to play through it again, do the worst possible run.
I mean the best run.
This is the most entertaining and blarney run. Because, yes. I mean, honestly, like, there are just so many playthroughs of this game. Well, especially in Polish, where, you know, in Poland this game was actually fairly popular. Everybody played it. And it was also one of the only games where if you said you pirated it, you would actually get banned from the forums. Because like everybody pirates games in Poland, or at least it used to be that way a lot more. But yeah. It's no secret that this franchise has become a lot bigger over time. The second game is much, much better.
Yeah.
Like, in nearly every possible regard, it is a superior sequel that I will be covering eventually, but likely not this way, or at least we're not going to be able to make choices the exact same way, since a lot of them are timed. So, yeah.
Yeah.
There's also the sequels much shorter and much better paced. It's a shorter game, but it has a lot more to it, so to say.
Instead of everything being in Chapter 2, everything is in Chapter 1.
No. Well, the most deaths are in Chapter 1, or the prologue, out of the entire game.
Aha!
But yeah. Now, if I were to load my game... Huh, weird. I remember there always being an option... I don't know if it... I remember there always being something weird when it came to loading the save file. I have never actually done that, to be honest. I don't think I have to manually save during the credits or anything like that. If I do, I'll just do that off screen. You know, we want to keep our good track record with all of the lands for the sequel,
yes.
If we ever cover it. I'll figure out a way to do it. But yeah, that was The Witcher. It was fun. I enjoyed it.
Yeah.